What does it mean for you to be a part of this year's Fright Fest lineup?
I'm honored. I think this is so exciting. It's actually my first time in London, so it's definitely been exciting, and I'm super stoked to be showing. This is the first time the movie's screened, so this is the first audience that's gotten to see the film. So just really excited to see what the response is going to be. So. It's a supernatural thriller. It's got a married couple that go out to the woods to kind of rekindle their romance. And one night they're camping not far from another group of campers, actually hunters. And they hear the hunters attacked by something, some creature in the woods. And the husband decides to go out of the tent and save one of the hunters who's injured. So they pull the injured hunter into the tent. And for some reason, the creature will not attack the tent, and they're not quite sure. So they're basically isolated inside of this tent with the injured hunter, played by Jake Busey. And the creature is kind of circling the tent, and they don't know why the creature won't attack, but they're kind of trapped. So it's very much a container film, but from that point, it becomes a psychological thriller between the three leads that are trapped inside the tent. So it's very, very claustrophobic and focuses a lot on performance. So. It was a challenge in the sense that we had to keep it interesting. I mean, when you're inside of a tent for two-thirds of a feature film, you're constantly thinking of shots, new ways to shoot a scene to keep it interesting for the viewer and so that it doesn't get stale. So it was a challenge just in terms of, like, we had a tent where we had to fit three actors. Jake Busey's, like, 6 feet tall. And we had to get the camera in there and the audio and all that. So it was a challenge. But, I mean, it's interesting because there's a lot of container horror films out there because they kind of lend themselves to smaller budgets, but it becomes a greater challenge for the director and for even the actors to keep the audience engaged in those small locations for that extended period of time. So, you know, every day I had storyboarded the film out shot for shot, but every day we'd take the storyboards as more of a roadmap. And I would basically say, okay, let's find a way of making this particular scene shot in a little bit different, from a different vantage point, to make each scene look different, so that the audience doesn't get bored with being stuck in one place for an extended period of time. So, horror it allows you to face your fears. I think a lot of people watch horror movies because it's cathartic to get scared watching a movie. I think there are different types of horror movies that appeal to people. Some people like slasher, some people like vampire movies, some people like a slower burn horror film. So I think what's great about horror is that there's different classifications of horror. Like I always say the romantic comedy genre isn't split up into different kinds of romantic comedies, it's just the romantic comedy genre. But horror, it's like there's supernatural, there's slasher, there's all these different things that appeal to a lot of different people. So I feel like that's why the horror genre, I think, continues to thrive, because there's just so much to offer. There's something for everybody, is what I'm trying to say. So, and our movie is definitely more of a psychological thriller. So I think it'll appeal to people who enjoy that kind of film. So, funny enough, I think the horror film that affected me the most as a kid was the first Friday the 13th, the very, very first Friday the 13th. I was born in 1980. The movie came out in 1980, and it was one of those movies where my parents were like, we don't want you watching this. And because they said that, it was like, I have to watch this movie. And it was always on cable, and so I would always try to watch it. And it's one of those movies that's kind of stuck with me over the years. Even the sequels I enjoy as well. And of course, my other favorite horror movie is Poltergeist, which is also came out when I was a kid. And I always thought it was a fantastic blend of supernatural horror and family drama. And so those are probably my two favorite horror films of all time. So that affected me the most as a child. So I would say that I think the criticism sometimes makes the genre even more interesting, because I think it's funny, because a lot of criticism is connected to horror films, but I think that makes it more interesting to people. And people want to see something that's criticized. They want to see, well, why shouldn't I be watching this movie? You know? And so I think that also makes people embrace it even more. I think, obviously, there isn't much controversy, again, with romantic comedies or anything like that. Controversy is just naturally connected to the horror genre. So I think that actually, for me, makes it more appealing, because I like to... I like to, you know, test the waters and see what people are, you know, interested in. I don't think there's going to be anything necessarily with Enclosure that makes people think, jump up and say, oh my God, you know, I can't believe they did that. But I think criticism always whenever I hear about a horror movie that's making the rounds as like a controversial film, I'm always immediately saying, I've got to see that film. So I think that helps the horror genre more than anything.